Resoliva Booking Engine and Channel Manager.
Building a multilingual WordPress hotel website. Building a WordPress website from scratch may seem intimidating for one who is not acquainted with the platform. Powering almost a quarter of the global web, WordPress is now a considerably advanced system, which means more ways of doing things, more stuff to choose from, and more topics to learn. But once this initial steep learning curve is overcome, it becomes very easy in the future to create a new site or maintain and update an existing one, which is a valuable talent to gain in today's world. This is not a detailed tutorial of building a WordPress site. There is plenty of information on that on the internet, like the video tutorials on YouTube and other channels. This is rather more of a general layout of building a WordPress site, and especially one for hotels, not covered in other resources. Step 1. Choosing a theme. This is the most difficult and comprehensive step of building a WordPress site. There are two alternatives: free themes at the WordPress.org site, and premium themes, or in other words, paid themes, at the various theme shops. Both options have advantages and drawbacks. Premium themes are generally less recognizable and therefore offer a more unique design. They usually have better help documents and support. Free themes, on the other hand, offer little to no support or documentation. Moreover, they may ask for an attribution link in return or offer limited features, which will result in buying additional ones. After deciding to continue with a free or a premium one, it comes to actually selecting the theme. Both WordPress site and online shops include a search feature, which can be used as a quick way of finding a suitable theme by simply typing in hotel. Following this method, however, would mean missing out on many nice themes which are not specifically designed for hotels, but can be easily customized for them, since hotel websites typically do not require much. This brings us face to face with a huge number of alternatives. In reality, on the other hand, few of these can actually be used for a multilingual hotel website. This is because WordPress is not a naturally multilingual system and requires plugins to become so. We can download plugins for this, however, only a fraction of the themes can support them. As a result of this, our selection criteria switches to finding the plugin that will be used for making the site multilingual. The most famous and perhaps the most developed of the multi-language plugins is a premium plugin called WPML. A search on the WordPress.org site for free plugins, on the other hand, yields a handful of results. Some of those make automatic translations, while some require multi-installations. For this tutorial, we leave these systems aside and concentrate on plugins that are for manual translations and single WordPress installations. Of these, PolyLang stands out with a higher number of users, better ratings, and user friendliness. After deciding on the translation plugin, we come back to finding the theme which supports it. There are a number of ways to do this. Reading theme details, typing in the individual plugin name in the theme search box, and typing in words like multilingual or multi-language in the theme search box. A satisfactory number of decent themes can be found this way. However, if a right-to-left language will be used on the site, like Arabic or Persian, then things get more complicated. Most themes, even when they support multilingual plugins, may not support right-to-left languages. In that case, right-to-left, or RTL support, in short, becomes the new selection criteria. And to find those special themes, we have to use the search functionality of theme shops and carefully read theme details. Having narrowed down the choice to themes which can work with the required languages, it then comes down to comparing individual themes one by one. At this step, design and user experience are the first things that come to mind. Some themes look really attractive and tempting, but it should not be forgotten that this is with the demo content on. It is crucial to imagine the theme with the hotel content on when making the buying decision, as it may not look as nice then. As soon as a number of candidate themes are chosen for design and user experience, they must be checked for speed, security, responsiveness, browser compatibility, and search engine friendliness. Many themes offer information as to whether they satisfy these conditions in their detail pages, and it is a good idea to read those carefully. There are also many online tools developed to check some of those attributes. The alternative, however, would be relying on the theme producer, overall customer ratings and reviews of the theme, and the theme selling shops, which make a basic filtering of what they are selling. WordPress itself also links to some premium theme sites that stick to the GPL policy, which can be taken as reliable. In addition to those, the current number of users give an important clue to the theme's popularity and therefore trustworthiness. WordPress makes this known by the active installs number, and theme shops usually announce the number of sales. Themes with a very low number, even when they have high ratings, are risky because they have not been checked by many users. More widely used themes are also more likely to be updated and supported in the future, as there is a wider community expecting this service. In addition to checking reviews and ratings, it is a good idea to check the support forums as well, to see what kind of problems are arising and how fast these problems, if ever, are addressed. While doing this research, it is quite likely to come across a phrase called framework. Framework can be seen as flexible templates from which many individual themes can be derived. From our perspective, this does not much change the things we are supposed to do, apart from a possible amount of small extra payment for the framework. Step 2. Installing WordPress. This is the easiest step, because almost all hosting providers offer applications to install WordPress with the click of a button. You can watch our previous video, Guide to Building a Hotel Website, for the basics of choosing a hosting provider. Some providers nowadays are also offering plans special to WordPress. If one of those is chosen, then it will not be necessary to perform the installation, as it will come ready, usually called Managed WordPress Hosting. These plans offer some advantages, like speed and automatic updates, but cost more. Step 3. Customizing WordPress. We will not go into the details of customizing WordPress. There is tons of information about that on the internet. In addition to the general features of WordPress, all themes have their own specifics when it comes to customization, which can be learned by trial and error or by referring to theme documentation. Video tutorials would also help, and if you can find a whole video tutorial for that specific theme, taking you from the beginning of WordPress installation to the end, that can mean jumping over the WordPress learning curve in a few hours. As soon as it is installed, it is a good idea to go to Settings at the WordPress admin panel and change the permalink setting to Post Name. Permalink settings determine how website URLs will look like, and the default permalink setting with the question marks, which WordPress comes with, is not the most SEO-friendly one. While at the Settings section, it is worthwhile to go to the Discussion setting as well and disable comments, since this feature is not necessary in a hotel website. This will substantially decrease the possibility of spam and therefore the necessity for anti-spam plugins. If there's going to be a blog page, then it is possible to allow comments for that page particularly from its own page settings. After that comes theme installation and activation. In a free WordPress theme, installation consists simply of searching the theme at the Appearance section of the admin panel and then clicking Activate. Otherwise, it is necessary to download the theme from the seller's site and then upload. Some themes may require individual plugins to work, or more than one file being uploaded. All of those details are normally specified in the theme documentation and instructions. At this step, it is a good idea to install the rest of the plugins that are going to be used before installing the multi-language plugin. The list of necessary plugins changes according to individual needs and what is expected from the website. For example, if you want to collect emails to send newsletters, then a newsletter or subscription plugin will be necessary. Apart from that, the following are a must-have for any hotel website. A backup plugin, to back up the website once it is built and later occasionally when there are updates. A caching plugin, which temporarily stores website data in caches to increase website loading speed. An SEO plugin, which enables optimizing the site for better search engine ranking for specific targeted keywords. A sitemaps plugin, which creates sitemaps of the site for better search engine results. And finally, a statistics plugin, to keep track of who's visiting the website. The following plugins may be necessary depending on the functionality expected from the website and those offered by the theme. A contact form plugin, if the theme does not have a contact form of its own. A pop-up plugin to announce special events, campaigns, and offers with a pop-up from time to time. A social media plugin to keep in touch with visitors online. A newsletter or subscription plugin for email campaigns. A security plugin to protect the website from attacks. And finally, a content delivery network or image optimizer plugin to further increase website speed. After these, the multi-language plugin can be installed. Once this is done, it is a good idea to check and confirm the compatibility of the theme before beginning customization. Like themes, the rest of the plugin should also be compatible with the language plugin. Luckily, if a particular plugin does not satisfy this, there are many alternatives. And finally, when we are sure that everything is working properly, we can begin customizing the site and adding content. This was a short tutorial on building a multilingual WordPress hotel website. For more detailed information and links to mentioned resources, the PDF document of this tutorial can be referred to by clicking the link in the description section or here. Thank you for watching.